Lincoln High School. Make some noise!
Allow anyone to stop you from doing what you want to do. What's most important is what I did after that. It is not where you start, it is where you finish. Some of you all are going through hell every single day. Every single day. But greatness comes out of adversity. I refuse to give up. And some of you in this room right now are giving up because you think it's just too bad. And I'm here to apologize to everyone in this room who's been mistreated, disrespected, for everyone in this room who's going back to a house right now where you don't have a dad or a mom or you got some real adult problems. I'm apologizing to you for all the people who have disrespected you, who have mistreated you. Aretha Franklin was a high school dropout. Greatness comes out of adversity. Everyone in this room wants to be something. That's why we go on and watch BET and MTV. You all want to be something. I'm going to tell you how to get it. How many of you in this room right now have someone in your family that's in prison right now? Raise your hand. There was a little girl at the detention center in Chicago. She couldn't get along with school. The principal asked me to talk to her, and I said, "What's wrong, dog?" She said, "My uncle's been raping me since I was 9 years old." And I'm going to tell you right now, if there's any girl in this audience right now that has somebody that's doing something to them or abusing them, you come tell me. I'll spend some time here with a police officer, and you'll fill out some reports and get somebody arrested. That's funny to you? Let me tell you something. Yeah, you have a smile on your face when I'm talking about a young girl being abused. Next time, I'm just going to bring your front. I'm not mad at you. That's part of the problem. We destroy it for a lack of knowledge. When I was in junior high school, I brought all the gum and candy I could in between classes and sold it to my classmates. By the time I was a freshman in high school, and I want my young black brothers and white brothers and Hispanic brothers to listen to this. Because you can be a criminal if you want to, but you are going to go to prison. The Secret Service arrested me, the people that protect the president. You will not get away with being a criminal. If you think you're nothing and hang around people that are nothing, you will be nothing. I couldn't have got to the airport if I had a bunch of bags in my hand trying to catch a plane. You have to drop excess baggage in your life. Y'all call them haters. Drop them. And some of the most negative people in your life can be people in your own house. Like success. You got people that don't like you, you don't have to get a gun to beat them up. Be successful. They'll see you. They will see you.
How many of you guys think it would be really cool to have someone pay you to go to school? Right?
How many people in this room, based on what you've heard already, would like to be a part of that group? Raise your hand. Okay. All right.
Good afternoon, my name is Victor Woods and it's been a pleasure to be here in Dallas, Texas. I had an opportunity to speak at James Madison High School under the leadership of Mrs. Smith, and I also had an opportunity to come to Lincoln School under the leadership of Ms. Veazey. And this has just been an excellent experience. I've been so privileged to have an opportunity to speak. I found each school to just have a tremendous amount of leadership under the auspice of both of those principals. And this is the type of program that I just enjoyed being involved in. We have especially young African-American children dying at an astronomical rate across this United States. And I was brought here by a young man by the name of Owes, who has a recycling company here, who just thought enough of me and thought enough of his community to bring me here to try to make a difference. And where I don't think that I change anyone's life, I think that I can help redirect lives. So I just want to say again that it's been such a pleasure to be in Dallas, Texas. It's been such a pleasure to be a part of this movement. And this is the exact type of thing that we need in the educational system. We need a new breath of fresh air, and we need to bring examples of people and think outside the box, because we are just losing a generation of young people. And rather than romanticize, philosophize, and pontificate on this matter, I had an opportunity to work with some people today that actually are making a difference and doing something. And I want to applaud both principals for having the courage to step forward and think outside the box and do some things that were meaningful. Because as my grandmother said, the truth is in the pudding. Don't be about it or talk about it, be about it. And we had an opportunity to do that. And I think really the pudding, or the proof in the pudding here, is the fact that these young people enjoyed that. And I think that's exemplified by what we saw today on video, and hopefully the audience will get a chance to see that. I'm very humbled, and I just want to thank everybody for the opportunity to come to Dallas, Texas, and hope to come here and do some meaningful things in the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
The program was a great program for the school to know about what we should do out there in the world.
I thought that it was great that he came here today, because I really needed that talk. I know I made a few mistakes in my life trying to be someone who I wasn't, and I understand now that I could just be me, and I could take my talents that I have and use them in another direction.
Man, Victor come out here and talk to us, because, I mean, I really haven't had any of those problems myself, but I know others have. I know people have come to me and asked me, but I couldn't really give them a correct answer because I can relate to them. And I'm just very thankful for him coming out here and giving us this knowledge.
Yes, this is Chanel Veazey, principal of the historic Lincoln High School in Dallas ISD in Dallas, Texas, here to just give a brief commentary on the Victor Woods. We had an outstanding motivational speaker here. He was dynamic. He motivated the students. They were innovative. They were moved to ask questions. He was engaged. He engaged the audience, and he was able to meet them where they are. The students at Lincoln High School are far better for having the opportunity to meet Victor Woods. Not only are the students better off, but the faculty and staff, our entire community here, we're better off for having the opportunity to experience Victor Woods. Thank you.